Hello, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to do the Dark Academia book tag. Now, no one tagged me in this and I don't super understand how tags work yet on YouTube since I am pretty new, but I saw this on a couple channels and I really wanted to do it, so I'm going to do it. This tag was created by Emma and CarolynMarieReads, and I will link their channels in the description. And let's just get started. So the first question is, what is your favorite academia or dark book and movie? Let's start with book. My favorite dark academia book is The Lake of Dead Languages by Carol Goodman. This is actually the UK cover because I bought it when I was living in London a long time ago. This book has been through it. I've given it to two friends, my sister. I've read it twice. It's really a well-loved book and I will never give it away. The Lake of Dead Languages follows Jane Hudson, who is a graduate of and current teacher at the Heartlake for School for Girls in the Adirondacks, is that how you say it correctly? In upstate New York. Basically, this book jumps between the past when she was a student and the present when she's a teacher. The past story is about her and her two best friends, who are also her roommates, Lucy and Deirdre, and what life was like for them going to school at this all-girls boarding school. Terrible tragedy happens while they're at school, and Jane is really the only one who walks away with the secret just destroying her. Fast forward to the present, Jane's in her late 30s. She's recently separated from her husband. She has a child and she comes back to the school, and pages of her missing diary that detailed a lot of what happened when she was in school start showing up. As soon as the pages start showing up, troubled girls start dying at the school and Jane starts to feel like it's all happening again. This is a very well-written and beautiful literary thriller, is how it's described, or mystery. I'm gonna read you the beginning. The lake in my dreams is always frozen. It is never the lake in summer, its water stained black by the shadows of pine trees, or the lake in fall, its surface stitched into a quilt of red and gold, or the lake on a spring night beaded with moonlight. The lake in my dreams reflects nothing. It is the dead white of a closed door, sealed by ice that reaches 60 feet down to the lake's glacial limestone cradle. Wonderful. My favorite dark academia movie is probably one that's not as popular as its contemporaries. So it's School Ties, which came out in 1992. The 90s were really a great time for film, in my opinion. I am a little biased since I was a teenager in the 90s, not in 1992. If you're not familiar, it takes place at a boarding school. It stars Brendan Fraser, Matt Damon, Ben Affleck, Chris O'Donnell, Anthony Rapp. It's like a Gen X, elder millennial dream cast. So it takes place in the 1950s and Brendan Fraser is the main character. He plays David Green, who is a young working class athlete who's also Jewish, who's very good at football. And his grades and his football abilities get him into a very prestigious boarding school in Massachusetts when he's a senior. So he's coming into school at the end of high school. He gets there very quickly, realizes that pretty much every single student there is anti-Semitic. You also have to remember the time period. It's the 1950s in the US. So they're like 10 years after World War II. When his Judaism comes to light, the true colors of the school come out. I really like this movie a lot. It's sometimes billed as like a sports movie because football does take a big part of it, but I think it more has to do with what these prestigious schools were like in that time period, and probably some are still today. I'd really recommend watching this movie. I actually asked my husband if we could watch it last night because I haven't seen it in a while and he loves it also, but he told me he'd watched it like 3 months ago without me and didn't want to watch it again yet. Second question is, which dead poet would you like to have a drink with? And it's a tie. Emily Dickinson, which a lot of women really, she really resonates with them. I did a huge paper on her when I was in high school and really fell in love with her poetry, but also Robert Frost. I really like Robert Frost's poetry. His most famous, Stopping by Woods in a Snowy Evening, or like I Took the Road Less Traveled, as him as well. They're probably my two favorites. Question three is, what is your favorite painting and what's your favorite sculpture? Painting is a really hard one for me because I'm more like painters, like specific painters, and I am an impressionist person. So my favorite painters are Monet, Degas, and Van Gogh. I find Monet's paintings extremely soothing to look at. I love Degas' ballet paintings, and I really like Van Gogh. My favorite sculptures are Rodin's The Kiss and Michelangelo's Pieta, which is the one with Mary holding Jesus after he's come down from the crucifix. We studied that in my dance class for a long time, that specific sculpture, so it really stuck with me. The fourth question is, what is your favorite architectural marvel? And mine is Stonehenge. I'm like a big Stonehenge fan. Visiting Stonehenge was one of the coolest things in my life. I know it's a weird choice because it's a marvel because of the time period. It's not that like interesting to look at unless you think about when it was actually built and the effort it took to put it together. For more of a modern architectural marvel, I'm really particular to Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. I went to Mass there on Easter in 2004, and it was beautiful. It was fantastic. You can take the girl out of French class, but you really can't take the French class out of the girl. The fifth question is, which Shakespeare main character would I like to play? I wouldn't necessarily want to play a main character, but my favorite Shakespeare play is Midsummer Night's Dream, and I would love to play Puck/Robin Goodfellow. I think that'd be a very fun character to play. I am not an actor. I am a writer, or I maybe could do set design. The sixth question is, how many languages do I speak and what language would I like to learn? I only fluently speak English. I used to speak French pretty well, but when you don't practice, it disappears. So I can say very few words in French. I wish my French could come back, but I would need to study. In terms of what language I would like to speak, if I could wake up and speak a language tomorrow, I would want to speak like Old Irish or like a Gaelic or Celtic language from the early part of the last millennium. I'm just really interested in that point in history. I would love if I walked through, if I touched a stone like Claire in Outlander and walked into, you know, 700 AD Ireland, that'd be a dream if I didn't die immediately. Okay, the next question, number seven, is what is your favorite quote? And I have a couple that I wrote down on my laptop so I would not misquote them. And they all have specific meanings. The first is Robert Frost. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. I have that on a poster hanging in my bedroom. I also, when I was in labor with my second child, I have a baby that was born on the winter solstice in the middle of the night, which is kind of cool. And that was one of the quotes that I focused on. Miles to go before you sleep. My next favorite quote is from Dr. Seuss, but I really recommend it if you're going through a hard time. It's from All the Places You'll Go. And it is, but on you will go though the weather be foul, on you will go though your enemies prowl, on you will go though the hacken cracks howl, onward up many a frightening creek though your arms may get sore and your sneakers may leak. On and on you will hike, and I know you'll hike far and face up to your problems, whatever they are. Listen, that's a really good quote, Dr. Seuss. That's really good writing. And then my last one is probably my favorite quote from college. It's from The Stolen Child by Yeats. For he comes, the human child, to waters and the wild with a fairy hand in hand, for the world's more full of weeping than he can ever understand. Those are three of my favorites. I also have a lot of favorite quotes from different books and from Shakespeare, but those are the ones that kind of stick out in my mind when people ask me for a quote that I love. Question eight is, which fictional character's death is like my ideal way to go? Do you know any characters who died in their bed when they were like 106? Because I don't romanticize death. Question nine is, which university or school would you want to attend? I've actually been really lucky and gotten to attend some pretty cool universities. I did my undergrad at Villanova University, which is in Pennsylvania. And if you're familiar, it's beautiful and has really cool architecture, and you definitely feel like you're the main character in a dark academia novel while you're there. I spent a semester studying in London and went to Queen Mary University, which is cool. It's not like Cambridge or Oxford, but you know, I lived in London, which is awesome. And I got a master's degree at a small university in Northern Illinois called Dominican, which is also really pretty and like gothic-y looking. But if I could get a PhD somewhere or another master's degree, which is my dream to get another master's degree. I mean, ideally, I would like to go to Trinity College in Dublin because of the library there is unreal. But realistically, I'd love to go to Northwestern University in Illinois because it's not, it wouldn't involve moving my family to a different country to go there. Yeah, I think there's a ton of beautiful universities. You can really make any university beautiful, and it's really what you put into it. Question 10, what is your murder weapon of choice? Candlestick over the head, definitely. I actually have a really big candlestick right there that would totally work. Question 11, what mythology would you most like to be a part of? Look, I'm a grown-up Greek mythology kid. I've been obsessed with Greek myths since I was 9 years old, and I will never stop. My copy of Dallaire's Greek mythology, I think, is behind me. Let me show you my copy of Dallaire's. This is my second copy. My first copy I had, I completely destroyed. And then I was working in a library and we had a copy of Dallaire's that was so beat, it was getting taken out of the collection. So I got to keep it. So that's the copy I have right now. And if you like Greek mythology, I don't care if you are a grown up, you should get this book. It's beautiful and it's amazing. I really wouldn't want to participate in the mythology, but I would like to just sit and watch specifically the goddesses, Athena, Artemis, Demeter, Hestia. When I was younger, I was all about Artemis and Athena. Now that I'm older, I really appreciate both Demeter and Hestia as goddesses. Question 12 is, if you got a PhD, what would you get it in? So I do have a master's degree in library information science, and I have no interest in getting a PhD in library information science. I would, if I was able, I would get master's degrees in like everything, but obviously I'm not. If I were to go back to school to get another master's and work it all the way to the PhD level, I would probably want to do the late antiquity time period, like a history PhD. Particularly in Europe, which is basically the fall of the Roman Empire through the Dark Ages. That is my favorite time period in history because so much of it sort of meshes between history and legend and folklore. I mean, I love Arthurian legend. That's the time period Arthurian legend is from. Question 13 is, which fictional character would you die for? This was a hard question for me because I don't tend to be one of those people who like looks at these characters as like my friends and family, but I would probably die for Samwise Gamgee from Lord of the Rings. I just love his character more than anything. He's fantastic. He's a great friend. He did all the work. So Sam. Okay, so the next questions are rapid fire, which I'm going to bring my laptop over here so I can read them quickly. The first is leather bound or cloth bound books. Cloth bound. I do not like the smell of leather at all. Question 2 is dog-earing the pages or highlighting them? Highlight. I don't bend my pages, but I do highlight. 3 is sculptures or paintings. I'm gonna have to go with paintings. 4 is piano or violin. That is hard for me. I love both those instruments, but I probably listen to piano more, but when I'm feeling really emotional, I need a sad violin, so I'm gonna go violin. Question 5, film or theater? Once upon a time, I would have picked theater, but I'm gonna have to go film now that we're living in a global pandemic. Question 6 is poetry or prose. As much as I love poetry, I read prose more, so we're gonna go prose. Question 7 is museums or bookshops. I'm going with museums. I've worked at a bookshop and it does, you know, dissipate a little bit of the magic having worked there when you know the employees are also thinking about random stuff like inventory and receiving. So museums. Museums are still magical to me. Question 8 is the smell of coffee or tea or books. And I have to go with books. Question 9 is a fountain pen or a typewriter. And again, because of my age, I lived in a time where our house had a typewriter and not a computer. And I was writing, you know, projects for school on a typewriter. And it is a pain in the ass. So fountain pen always. And the last question is new or used books. And I have to go new. It's funny, I do like owning used books and I love the library, but if I'm gonna buy myself like a special book, with the exception of if it's a rare book, I kinda wanna be the first owner and then pass it along when I'm done with it. So that is the Dark Academia book tag. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you're having a Dark Academia day and maybe you're learning a little bit of Latin while you drink your black coffee and stare at the moon. Bye.